Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Huskers in Enemy Territory. Today, I was going to speak on the start of the football season for the Nebraska Corn Huskers. I know spring training's about to end here in a few weeks. May 1st is going to be the spring game. So, I felt like it would be a great time to maybe start a series on what kind of expectations the Corn Huskers should have. And how we could probably win against some of the teams that we have on our schedule. The first game is going to be against Illinois in Champaign. I kind of hope that I'm going to be able to go to that game. I'm not sure, of course, what the rules and regulations will be for the state of Illinois in terms of like the COVID restrictions. So I would definitely have to go and look at what is going on with that, but and if it's I mean, obviously it's going to be around late August, early September when the game is played. So hopefully by then restrictions have been lifted a little bit and I'll be able to go to the game in Champaign. The last time I went, it was I believe in 2015. And we ended up losing. Hopefully, it wasn't because of me. I'm pretty sure it was because of a couple stupid calls that went the Illinois, the Illini way. And hopefully this year will be a little bit different. And let's kind of dive into what I was thinking on the whole thing. Last year, the Illini absolutely kicked our butt. The Huskers lost 43 to 23. And to be honest, I ended up turning off the game when it was at halftime because at that point, Luke McCaffrey had thrown two interceptions and we had fumbled the ball twice. So, if we're being honest, I had to rewatch the highlights just of the game just to kind of recall what happened in that game. I was absolutely disgusted with almost the whole game. The defense couldn't stop. The kid, number two, Chase Brown, he had 110 yards on the ground on 13 carries. That's absolutely insane. An 8.7 yards per carry average. He had two touchdowns on the ground in that game. He just absolutely dominated the Huskers. And honestly, I would have stripped all the black shirt jerseys from all those players off that performance right there. And that's just my opinion on that. Like I said, McCaffrey had two interceptions at that point, and there was two fumbles right before halftime. So kind of my thoughts on how do we fix this before the beginning of the game. I was thinking it would be kind of a three-pronged attack, really. So, number one, turnovers. In that game alone, we had four turnovers, which I believe resulted in three touchdowns and a field goal. So, right there, that's 24 points. We eliminate that right there. It's more of a manageable game, right? We had 23. You don't know what could have happened with our drives on those turnovers, but of course, hopefully you expect touchdowns, but maybe we get field goals. If we get field goals, that possibly could have pushed us over the top and we could have won that game. You never know. So that's why I have turnovers as number one. If the black shirts get tons of turnovers, hey, that's good for us. Like, we just need to address the turnovers in general as a team. And that's, I think, one way we can fix the Huskers versus Illinois next year. Two, penalties. Last year, Nebraska ranked 90th in penalties with an average of 6.8 penalties per game. We just really need to cut that shit out. I get that. I understand that there's penalties in the game, right? But 6.8, almost 7 penalties a game, that's ridiculous. We need to really cut that down to even half. Like get it to 3 like per game or something. You know what I mean? Like I know a lot of it is where people still feel like Nebraska's kind of getting penalized for being the new guy in the Big Ten. And I'm not sure if there's any truth to that, but we just really need to figure out how to cut down on those penalties. Third, I kind of had it threefold, or not threefold, two-sided, really. I have Adrian Martinez and the offensive efficiency. If Adrian Martinez starts out in the game and he's just playing like absolute shit, turn the ball over, just doing dumb plays. I know a lot of that's on the offensive coach and whatnot, but we really need to get off to a quick start. I mean, I just don't know how to really, dang it, I'm lost of words. I should have written it down. I didn't write it down. I thought I could kind of go off the top of my head, but just offensive efficiency, like, it's almost like I already put out, right? With the turnovers, with the fumbles, the interceptions, we just really need to be more efficient with the football, running the ball more. If I feel like if we kind of go back to what got Nebraska to the national championship games, which was running the ball, I think that would really help with Adrian Martinez's confidence. I feel like he's a better runner than he is a passer by far. If we could really get his running game down, even just hand the ball off like, 2 or 3 times in a series, like right off the bat, just really getting him in a good rhythm, Maybe do a jet sweep with him or something, just get him like going, and then maybe dabble with a screen pass or a couple slants or whatever. You know what I mean? Like just kind of get him into the flow of the game before really like trying to push the ball down the field like we have in the past. I don't know. There's just I just hope there's a good game plan. I hope Coach Lubbock can figure it out and really improve this offense down the road versus Illinois in this next this first game of the year. Just to hit on one note, a good friend of mine from the Navy, he ended up purchasing 5 Husker and enemy territory stickers from me, and I really appreciate that. I'll be sending those out. Some of my friends on Instagram, on the House of Cards Instagram page, they requested a couple stickers as well, so I'll be sending those out next week. If anyone would like to help support my channel, I will be doing Huskers in enemy territory t-shirts. I haven't figured out how much they will cost yet, but there will be a little bit of a markup on them just to try and help out the channel. I really want to get a new camera so I'm not taping on my cell phone anymore. Just a couple ways of getting the a little bit of revenue coming in for the channel. My wife kind of joked at me about starting a Patreon. I mean, that would be nice, but right now I'm just trying to focus on how to make videos a lot better and just eventually start editing some of these videos so you have a little bit of like whatever you want to call it, graphics and whatnot, to the video as well, that's about it, really. Don't forget about the 500 subscriber giveaway. I'll be doing the giveaway once I hit 500 subscribers. It's an Adrian Peterson drawn picture. Hopefully you guys kind of excited for that. I know I am. And that is totally free, sent to you by me, no charge. So this will be the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed the video, and as always, go Big Red.